Hi everyone, all of you are most welcome in my channel and your study channel also. Today in class 9th biology, the chapter name is tissue. We will study about the permanent tissue, because we earlier studied about the definition of tissue, differentiation, cell division and meristematic tissue. Today it is turn of simple permanent tissue. Simple means permanent tissues. Permanent tissues. Permanent tissues. Dear students, permanent tissues are that type of tissues that originates from meristematic tissue, means meristematic cells. Okay, permanent tissues are those tissues which originates from meristematic cells. They lost their ability to divide and become permanent in certain fixed locations of the plant body and have same, means similar, shape, size and functions, because the cells are specialized in a group for a particular function and that function for a tissue is same. Okay, so you can write the characteristics in this way, that permanent tissues are those tissues which originates from meristematic tissues. Okay, they are made up of mature cells, permanent cells, which have similar shape, size and functions and become fixed at certain locations of the plant body. They lost their ability to divide. They can be living or dead, both type. They can living or dead. They, if they are living, the cell will be large, having spiculated cytoplasm and a prominent nucleus. And if the cell is dead, then the cell will be small and do not have cytoplasm. Maybe nucleus is also absent. Okay? So let's write the definition. Permanent tissue is group or collection of living or dead cells originates from meristematic cells and become fixed at certain locations of the plant. Okay, they lost their ability to divide. Okay, they lost their ability to divide, but they are living. So they perform the metabolic functions in the plant body if they are living. And if they are living, they also large in size, having thin cell wall that encloses the cytoplasm and nucleus, and that cell wall can be made up of cellulose or pectate. Okay? So this will be the definition. Okay? These permanent tissues are of two types. The simple, what is permanent? Permanent tissues can be divided into two categories, and these categories is one of simple permanent tissue and the another is complex permanent tissue. Okay, two types, simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue, these are two types. Okay, I think you will understand. Permanent tissues is the group of living or dead cells, originates from meristematic cells and lost their ability to divide and become fixed at certain locations of the plant. Okay, they can be of two types, simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue. So today our topic, the next topic will be the simple permanent tissue. Okay, dear students, as the name is simple permanent, so these are called simple permanent tissues because the cells of the tissues, cells of the tissue are unspecialized. What? They are not specialized. Unspecialized. Okay? Means unspecialized. Okay? Means ki they have similar shape, size and functions. Similar shape, size and functions. Okay, as they are permanent, so they lost the capability, means ability to divide, and that's the things that they are fixed, they become fixed at certain locations of the plant. Okay, so these are some characters, you can easily understand them. Now depending these simple permanent tissues are also further categorized into three categories, and these categories are, one is called parenchyma, second is called collenchyma, and the third one is called sclerenchyma. You have to remember the names of tissues, meristematic tissues, then permanent tissues that originates from the meristematic tissues in cell, meristematic cells, and lost the capability to divide. So those permanent tissues are further divided into two categories, and these two categories are, one is the simple permanent tissue and second is the complex permanent tissue. Okay, this is simple permanent tissue is called simple because they are the group of unspecialized cells. Okay, and They are also called simple because they have the similar structure, shape and functions. Okay. So they lost their capability to divide, as you know, which is the property of all kind of permanent tissues. Okay. So let's know something about the parenchyma. Okay. That is a type of simple permanent tissue. Okay. Look here, parenchyma. Okay, this parenchyma is group of living cells. These parenchymatous cells are living. Means this tissue is made up of living cells. Means thin cell wall made up cellulose encloses vacuolated cytoplasm and nucleus. Dear students, vacuolated means with vacuole. Means in meristematic tissues the cells are having abundant cytoplasm and a large prominent nucleus. They will have the very small and few number of vacuoles or no vacuolata. But here, after differentiation, these cells become vacuolated. Means they will have a large and centralized vacuoles. Okay? You can write here. Vacuole is large and centralized in position. Okay. Next, that these cells have intercellular space. Intercellular space, you know, the space between cell to cell. Okay. So you can at that point also ki they have intercellular space. Okay. So these are some characters. Parenchyma is the group of living cells. If they are group of living cells, they are large in size, having cytoplasm that enclosed by a primary cell wall. That cell wall can be made up of cellulose or pectin. Second thing, the cytoplasm is vacuolated, means they will have the large centralized vacuole. Okay, and they have intercellular space. Okay, next you can write here. These are the most abundant cells in plants. Okay, बहुत ज़्यादा पूरे plant body में बहुत ज़्यादा parenchyma होता है. ठीक है, तो you can see these points. Now let's talk where they are located in the plant body, where they are distributed in plant body. Distribution, we just studied the characters. Distribution. Okay, parenchymatous tissue are widely distributed in all parts of the plant. Means they are widely distributed in root, stem, leaves, flowers and fruits. Means they are found in all parts of the plant. These are root, stem, leaves, flower and fruits. Then they form ground tissue, base. Ground tissue in cortex, pericycle, pith, endosperms of seed, mesophyll of leaves, pulp of fruit. They are widely distributed. They are found in all these regions. Okay. So this question is very important. We name the locations in plant body where parenchymatous tissue are found. So you can write this. Okay. They can be found in root, stem, leaves, okay, flower and fruits, all parts. And if you go some specialized, then cortex, pericycle, okay, pith, endosperm of seed, mesophyll cells are the leaves. Now you see here, pericortex. Cortex is a piping tissue, okay. It is formed between the specialized tissues. Between the specialized tissues, this parenchyma tissue is found and it forms the ground tissue, means spiking tissues. Okay. Pericycle. Peri means surround and cycle means circular. So it is found in many parts like the stem. You can take the examples. Xylem and phloem found inside the pericycle. It encloses those. Okay. That is the pericycle. Pith is, if you ever tested orange, I think all of you, so that cover of the fruit of orange, that the yellowish part that is thicker, that is called pith. Okay. Similar type of in other fruits also. So that is the covering, that white covering that come out from inner side, that hole is the pith. So they are found in pith also. Endosperms of the seeds, as you know that we are making bread for our food from wheat. So that whitest part is actually the endosperm, okay, along with the seed. That endosperm provide nutrition to the seed when the seed is germinating state. Okay, so that is the endosperm of seed. Mesophyll are the leaves. So mesophyll cells are the special type of cells which have the chlorophyll in them. Okay, so those cells are called mesophyll. So mesophyll cells are also parenchymatous in origin. Okay, pulp of fruit, pulp, you know, it is the jisko guda kehte hain. So in sare jagahon pe parenchymatous tissue is present. Okay. Now there are certain types also in parenchymatous tissue. Okay. So let's talk about their types. Okay. Depending on the location and functions in the plant body, parenchyma can be storage parenchyma, or it can be chlorenchyma, it can be the arenchyma. Okay, look here. In plants, the storage parenchyma, as name itself dictating, that storage parenchyma performs the function of storage of ready-made food in the plants, like the carbohydrate, protein, fat. This type of food are stored in the parenchymatous cell. So when parenchymatous cell modified for the storage purpose, they are called the storage parenchyma. Chlorenchyma, as I said just before sometime, mesophyll cells. So mesophyll cells will have the chlorophyll, and such type of cells which have the chlorophyll in them, okay, they are called the chlorenchyma. Means the parenchymatous tissue or cell that modified for the photosynthesis, for the function of photosynthesis, they are called chlorenchyma. And arenchyma, in some plants the parenchymatous cells form the cavities, and those cavities trap the air, and that trapped air help the plant, aquatic plant, to float on the water. Okay, they provide buoyancy, as you are studied in physics perhaps. So that arenchyma helps the plant to float in water, like you can take the example of hyacinth, jalkumbhi jisko kehte hain, bahut sare logo ne dekha bhi hoga, and those who not seen, they try to visit the nature after long term. Okay, don't visit this time, but you can easily see this time this hyacinth, like lotus also. So they will have the air cavities in them. In succulents also, succulent type of plant, like you can take the example of cactus, that have the fleshy leaves. In fleshy leaves, these parenchyma store water also, okay, in succulent plant. So these are some types and their functions of the parenchymatous tissue. You can write here, function is also same. You have to mention this heading, functions of parenchyma. Okay, so you can write parenchyma makes the ground tissue means packing, basic, okay, tissues. Second thing, they perform the function of storage and called storage parenchyma. Okay, you can write in succulents, means plants having fleshy leaves, they store water and aquatic plants they provide floating ability. Floating ability by trapping the air trapping air in cavities. Okay. In plants, they involve in the function of photosynthesis and they are called the chlorenchyma. So you can mention this function also. Okay. So this is the parenchyma. Let's draw the diagram of parenchyma and you will understand why diagram, because we not say, I not said about the shape. You can write here shape. Okay. Parenchymatous cells are of various shapes. What are those shapes? They can be cylindrical, spindle shape, rectangular. Rectangular, stellate, many shapes are there. Okay, stellate, stars. Okay, so they can be found in any shape. Okay, let's draw the diagram. Suppose this is the spherical. Okay. This type you can make the diagram in your copy also. Okay. As I said, they have a centralized vacuole. You can make angle diagram also in this way. Vertical section and transverse section like this. Everywhere there is the intercellular space. And as you studied in class 8 that they appear like the bricks in wall. So similar type of picture I am drawing here also. It appears like bricks of wall. Okay. Dear students, in biology, diagram is very necessary because if you sometimes everyone go through this situation that you missed something. Okay. So this diagram will help you to score good marks in exams. Okay. This I am drawing, this resembles the cytoplasm. Okay. This resembles the cytoplasm. In this way, and the nucleus, as you know, in most cases of the plants, the nucleus is peripheral in position, so nucleus is not generally centralized. Okay, these parenchymatous cells are living cells. Okay, while all permanent tissues will not have the living cells, not made up of living cells. The primary cell wall. In cells, those having the primary cell wall, they certainly will live in, because secondary cell wall made up of lignin or pectin, and lignin or pectin are impermeable and they do not allow anything to go across through the cell. but as you studied in your previous chapter that cell needs the supply of regular supply of materials from surrounding to complete its functions and continuously removal of this product from it to maintain the equilibrium of the body. Okay, so in that condition, if the secondary cell wall will arise, that cell will not able to get the supply of required materials because the secondary cell wall is impermeable. It does not allow anything to go across through it. Okay, so you can make anywhere a nucleus. Dear students, if you are able to understand the topic, if you are learning something in biology, then I requested many times and again I will request. Okay, this is for your benefit also and for me also. Okay, so your benefit is my benefit. If you will be succeeded, I also. This outer side is the cell wall. Okay, this space is intercellular space. Okay, this is the cytoplasm and this centralized space is vacuole. Okay, so dear students, this type of diagram you can draw in your copy also and write each point, what points are there. These points are like the characteristics. Okay, then distribution means occurrence, where they occur. Okay, afterward their shape, then types, afterward function, and then diagram figure you have to draw. Okay, try to draw the figure with properly labeled. Okay, label diagram are those diagram whose parts are mentioned properly. Okay, so that is all about today because video becoming too long. So in next day, whenever I will prepare the video, I will discuss about the other two types of simple permanent tissues are Parenchyma and Sclerenchyma. Don't confuse with the name. Parenchyma is a type of simple permanent tissue, while Parenchyma is a type of parenchymatous tissue. Okay, stay home, remain safe. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe and share if you get anything to learn from this video. Thank you. Stay home, remain safe. Thank you very much.